संपूर्ण विश्व पर अपने अद्भुत व्यक्तित्व की अमिट छाप छोड़ने वाले स्वामी विवेकानंद के प्रभामंडल से आज हर हिंदुस्तानी का दिल रोशन है। स्वाभिमान, आत्मविश्वास और अंतरात्मा की शक्ति और देवत्व के उनके पैगाम को सलाम करने आ रहे हैं शारदा चिल्ड्रन फोरम नई दिल्ली के बच्चे।
स्वामी जी ने कहा, जिसमें आत्मविश्वास नहीं है वह नास्तिक है। प्राचीन धर्मों में कहा गया है, जो ईश्वर में विश्वास नहीं करते वह नास्तिक है। नूतन धर्म कहता है, जिसमें आत्मविश्वास नहीं है वह भी नास्तिक है। उन्होंने आगे कहा, संसार का इतिहास उन थोड़े से व्यक्तियों का इतिहास है जिनमें आत्मविश्वास था। यह विश्वास अंतस्थित देवत्व को ललकार कर प्रकट कर देता है, तब व्यक्ति कुछ भी कर सकता है, सर्व समर्थ हो जाता है। अतः सर्वप्रथम हम में पूर्ण आत्मविश्वास होना अत्यंत आवश्यक है।
तुम्हारे अंदर पूर्ण शक्ति निहित है, तुम सब कुछ करने में समर्थ हो। इस शक्ति को पहचानो, यह मत समझो कि तुम निर्बल हो। सारी शक्ति तुम्हारे अंदर विद्यमान है। उठो और अपने अंतस्थ दिव्यता को अभिव्यक्त करो।
Request the Honorable Minister of Culture, Srimati Chandresh Kumari Katoch, to deliver the welcome address.
Swamiji's ideas and teachings are relevant even today. It is therefore befitting for us to gather here to pay homage to the great son of India. Swamiji was extremely modern in his outlook and beliefs. He advocated that India should master the Western science and technology without losing roots of Indian culture. 150 years ago, Swami Vivekananda made a mark with his teachings in not only India, but also the Western world. You would recall that it was in Chicago Swamiji delivered his world famous address in the Parliament of World's Religions. I'm glad to inform you that as part of the 150th anniversary celebrations, we are also engaging the American institutes, including the Art Institute and University of Chicago, for spreading awareness about the teachings of Sri Swami Vivekananda. Considerable work has been done in the last 2 years for the commemorations. A national committee has been constituted under the chairmanship of the Honorable Prime Minister. A national implementation committee has also been constituted, ably guided first by our Honorable Rashtrapati Ji, and now the finance minister, was then the finance minister, and now she, Anthony G, is heading this committee. Various activities are being taken up in the country, within our country and with the Western world. The government of India has extended substantial financial assistance to the Ramakrishna Mission as a part of the celebrations. The chief aim of inculcating morals and spiritual values in the minds of the young people and to create awareness in the youth about the greatness of Indian culture and also motivate them to play an important part in nation building. With these words, I once again thank you very much for coming to this inaugural function. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Srimati Katoj. May I request the General Secretary, Ramakrishna Mission, Belur, Swami Suhitanandaji, to kindly address us.
Respected President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, respected Srimati Sonia Gandhiji, Honorable Ministers, Sri A.K. Antony, Sri P. Chidambaram, Sri Kapil Sibal, Srimati Chandresh Kumari Katoj, Secretary of Ministry of Culture, Monastics, and other distinguished participants. This function, organized by the Government of India, signifies the recognition of Swami Vivekananda's great love, services, and sacrifices for his motherland by the government, which is undoubtedly the first of its kind. Swami Vivekananda was one of the earliest spiritual leaders in India to speak for the downtrodden masses. He believed that all social transformations could be brought about through proper education, or to put it rightly, through transformation of our individual sanskaras. Swamiji wanted Indians should master Western science and technology, business administration, and solve their economic problems. And as a result, India is today one of the superpowers. Simultaneously, Swamiji said, excess of knowledge and power without holiness makes human beings devils. So what we need today is to awaken the moral and spiritual consciousness of our youth through proper value education. The youth, which constitutes nearly 40% of the total population of India, is potentially the most valuable human resources of the country. With the aim of spreading value education among the youth, the Ramakrishna Mission started in the middle of 2010 several value-based service projects through 300 units spread across 22 states, having a budget of rupees 50 crore. During the last 2 years, the Ramakrishna Mission has published and is being distributed 46 lakh copies of value education books on 148 titles in 22 languages, having a budget of rupees 30 crore. We greatly appreciate the initiative that the Government of India has taken to institute a Vivekananda chair at the University of Chicago, along with various programs in different countries through different embassies. I am glad to mention that very recently the UNESCO has created a chair in Ramakrishna Mission Vivekananda University. We take this opportunity to express our gratitude to respected President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, Srimati Sonia Gandhiji, Sri P. Chidambaram, and other ministers for taking keen interest in this project and for extending substantial financial assistance from the government. We are also thankful to the Honorable Defense Minister, Sri A.K. Antony, who is now the chairman of the National Implementation Committee, for continuing the support. I would request the government to continue its support in some form even after 2014 for having a sustainable effect throughout the country. May Swami Vivekananda inspire us all. Hidayo Ninang Naramurti Mantam Viveko Anandam Ahang Namami. Namaskar.